Hi, it's Michelle with Masterpieces with Michelle. How are you? Today is Saturday, April 11th, and I am doing my daily sketch in my 365-day book. So this is the 11th day that I've been doing it. And you know, it was a friend of mine brought up something to me yesterday as she was watching my videos. And so what I'd like to offer to you is that as I'm drawing these videos, or as I'm drawing out my little image, if you want to either maybe draw an image in your head, or you know, like sometimes you can use just utilize your imagination, or if you want to grab a piece of paper and a pencil, or some colored pencils, or you know, whatever works for you, crayons, markers, anything, and just draw what I'm drawing, and then I'll show you what I have at the end, and then you can kind of compare, and we'll just do it together. How's that sound? So, all right, so my drawing prompt today is draw a map of your neighborhood from memory. So I am looking at this and I'm thinking, okay, draw a map of my neighborhood from memory. And so is it my neighborhood that I live in now? Is it my childhood neighborhood? Which neighborhood is it? So that's my first question. I think I'm going to draw the one that I have now. And then my second one is, what perspective do you want? And Debbie, actually, my friend Debbie Happy Cohen with Joy Based Living, actually also mentioned that her visual muscle is improving just by like watching me and hearing me talk about my different perspectives. So if I'm going to draw a map of my neighborhood, a map would be looking down topographically, like where you're looking down this way. But could it be as you're driving along and seeing the different vehicles? Could it be that way? Or not the different vehicles, you're driving along in the vehicle and seeing the different cars. Could it be that way? Or could it be, I don't know. It's totally up to you. So I'm actually going to draw the map of my neighborhood that I currently live in now. And I did not look out to see how many houses are on my street, because I have a cul-de-sac at the end of my street. And so I'm going to do it like this. And here's my cul-de-sac. And I did not leave room for my houses at the end. Okay, so let's see. So there's the first house that is here. And they come in. And, you know what? Their driveway is black, so I'm going to use black too. And their house is, actually it's more of like a yellow. I'm going to use this one. And it's a longer house. It's the one that's on the corner. So I'm not going to get into all the details of what that looks like. I'm just going to draw a block. There. Yep. And then I have the next house is gray. And these guys have little bushes, so I'm going to give them some bushes. Very simple. Doesn't have to be, you know, it's a sketch. Does not have to be perfect by any stretch. So the next house also has a driveway. And they've got some trees in their front lawn. So I'm gonna, and I know that they have, let me see, I think they have a pool in their backyard. So I'm gonna do, there we go. There's a little pool. And then they have like the cage that goes around it. There we go. All right. And so they have trees. I've got one tree here, and they've got a couple of trees here, and some around. Then there is the next house, which is. Yeah. So as you're doing, you can just do the little squares for the houses. So that's kind of what I'm doing. This one I think has a little bit wider driveway than what I had drawn out. And so when you're thinking about this one, yeah, has a tree over here. When you're thinking about like your neighborhood, what do you think about your neighbors and how wonderful they are when your neighbors, do you have the kind of neighborhood that when somebody new moves in that you bake them cookies and take them over and welcome them? Or do you guys have like events, like maybe block parties and stuff? Just to kind of, you know, spend some time with each other. All right, so then the next house is, nope, it is more of like a brown. Well, this is moss. That'll work. And they have a little driveway. Okay. And they're a little bit wider. And they don't have a pool. They have a swing set in the back. So, let's see. I'm gonna do a swing set. All right, and then we have a yellow house. So what does your drawing look like? Mine has 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm working on the fifth house right now. And I don't know if they have a pool or not. So I'm just not gonna make it. And then we've got, then we start to go around the houses, around the end of the cul-de-sac. So that first one is probably the same beige color. Oh, and the next one is green. And think about, you know what I think about? I think about like the holiday decorations. Like how they do their lights and that kind of thing. There we go. And we've got another one here. And then another one here. And their house is more like a, this will work. They have that end house, and I know they have a pool in the backyard. And they actually have, they have a son who's like 7. And so they built a skate ramp in the back because they've got that corner lot. And it's so much fun. Not that I've done it, because I would, actually. I totally would. But so there's that one. And the next house is gray. Funny story. So my son, I have a 14-year-old son, and he was learning how to ride his bike, and he had just gotten to the point to where he's able to ride his bike and, you know, like make it down the street and everything. And he came down our driveway and he started going down toward the cul-de-sac. And actually ended up running into the mailbox at this house, and it was one of those moments. You ever have those moments where something happens and it's all in slow motion? So my son hit the mailbox at this house, and it was like the mailbox went like this. Clunk. Like, it took forever, and I'm going, holy Toledo, what do we do? So, you know, of course, we did the right thing. We went up, we knocked on the door, we offered to pay for it, and took care of all of that. So, and since then, they have one of those concrete flower pots around their mailbox, just, you know, just in case. So, it's, yeah. All right, so the next one is here, and that house is also, we'll make it this terracotta color. So as you're drawing, what colors are your houses in your neighborhood? Do you live in the mountains? Do you live at the beach? Do you live in the city? Do you have, so would this actually look like if you live like in an apartment or whatever in the city, would it look more like the apartment buildings, or would it look like your neighbor's doors? Let me think. So that's that one. That's, so then the next one is, excuse me, I think it's also green. It's funny, I've actually never even thought about the colors of these houses. You know, you just kind of go about your daily life. And then the next one is gray. Oh, no, it's not. The next one is, I think this one, yeah, it is. It's light gray. And then the one next to it is a dark gray. That's what it was. That's where I was getting confused. Okay, now I need a dark gray, and I'm gonna have to see if this will work. Yeah, it's good enough. And then the last one is gonna make it this color. And so we all have driveways. And I think, this one has a pool in the back too. All right. So what does your drawing look like? Leave me a little message and let me know. So this is, you know what? I'm going to. So I hope that you're able to draw with me. I would very much like for you to draw with me. I've mentioned before in 2020, one of my things is to spend 20 minutes drawing a day or doing some kind of art-related activity, because it helps presence you, and it helps kind of bring you back to that moment. So this is what my drawing is for the day. And again, it's April 11th. Draw a map of your neighborhood from memory. So that's what I have for today. I hope that you are drawing and doing some kind of self-care and being good to you. I know that right now we've got the Rona going on, and sometimes it's tough. So doing something like this for just 20 minutes will help ground you again and get you back into a really good space where you can start to deal with things and kind of clear up some mental space in your mind, because sometimes when we're overwhelmed with things, it takes up a lot of space and we need something to decompress with. This is good. This is something that would be very easy and good for you. So, or for all of us. All right, so remember, doodle the residue of your day away, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.